me and him are like, you know, it's like our emotional life is the same, because he was dealing with his mom and dad, and I was dealing, you know, my dad got taken away from me young, and my mom, I had to watch my mom cry and suffer. Me and my dad lived totally different lifestyles. I was 16 years old. You know, he made sure I was in private school even when he went to jail. He was too embarrassed to even go to school because he had holes in his shoes and he was so poor. But not even that, it was just a different era back then. The violence, Detroit was, not to mention Detroit was like the number one capital, in the world back then. And it was just filled with poverty and crime and drugs and violence, you know. So it was, he didn't have the same opportunities I had. So saying that was, I had to put myself in his shoes and understand the obstacles that he had to overcome, you know, back then at such a young age, because he was already a man back then, the man of the house, taking care of his family at 15 years old. And, you know, we lived two totally different lifestyles, like I said. So, but me and him are like, you know, it's like our emotional life is the same, because he was dealing with his mom and dad, and I was dealing, you know, my dad got taken away from me young, and my mom, I had to watch my mom cry and suffer. Anytime I had a scene with my mom, you know, or anything like that that was emotional, I just took myself back to the little boy, you know, so, you know, I could really understand and bring my emotions back to, you know, to where to exactly where I feel everything, you know. So, for example, when my mom had a scene, me and my mom had a scene where she's telling me, you know, I got to choose drugs or the house. You know, it's like, what am I supposed to do? I'm trying to take care of my family, but you don't want to allow me to, because you're saying, you don't want me to sell drugs no more, but there's nothing else we can do to get the money. So it's like, you know, it's that emotional of heartbreak between you don't want to let your mom go, you don't want to move out the house, but you have to. So, you know, I learned to deal with it just because I dealt with my dad being taken away from me so young. It's kind of like the same thing, you know, and my mom didn't understand me growing up. We always used to bump heads. So it was like really like similar lifestyles. As a first-time actor, I mean, I want to show people that I know what I'm doing, and this is the role of my father. So it's like, I have something to prove. Just because I'm my dad doesn't mean I get the job. So I had to show people that, you know, that I really knew what I was doing. 50 Cent put me in acting classes for 2 years. He made sure that, you know, I had the foundation of acting before I just jumped out there on screen and didn't have any acting experience, you know, as far as any classes. I was in intense acting classes 5 days a week, 2 times a day sometime for 2 years, you know, just so I could have the foundation of acting, because I still had to audition for the show. Just because 50 wanted me to play my dad doesn't mean that I was just going to get the job. 50 really, you know, he really did it by making sure that everybody was happy. He didn't want to do it his way. He wanted to do it to where my dad and my family was proud, and that's what meant the most, you know, because everybody's proud. Like, my dad is happier than ever right now. I've never heard him this happy on the phone. I'm just glad everything works out so well, and I hope people love it.